Hi, I'm Bilkis Bahari and you're watching Interview of the Day. The Association of Southeast Asia, or ASEAN, was established on 8 August 1967. The 10 member countries have adopted ASEAN Vision 2020, where the countries agreed to create one shared vision as a region. Joining me in today's interview is former Indonesian Foreign Minister, Mr. Hassan Wirayuda. Welcome to the program, Mr. Hassan.
Thank you very much.
One of the most talked about topic in the world is building a common future between Eurasian countries. But before we discuss about Eurasia, let's talk about ASEAN. You know, it's a region that is home for both of us. ASEAN has a vision to establish the ASEAN community by 2020. Do you think that ASEAN could achieve this goal?
Actually, the ASEAN community has been established and it is based on the ASEAN Charter, which the 10 countries agreed in 2008, and the new charter has been effective since 2009. And under the charter, the ASEAN community is being implemented under three main pillars: economic, political and security, as well as socio-cultural. So in that context, we have begun to implement the ASEAN community. We have drafted and we have agreed on what we call the blueprints. The blueprints in the ASEAN economic community means there would be a free flows of goods, services, capital, and labors. So by 2020, we believe we have been quite advanced the economy cooperations among ASEAN, likewise on the political and security and the socio-cultural. To me, the greatest achievement of ASEAN in the past 51 years is that we enjoy continuously relative peace and security. This allowed us, allowed the regions to focus our time, energy, and resources for our economic development. That's why economically ASEAN is a very dynamic region.
One of the goals of ASEAN Vision 2020 is ensuring a peaceful and stable region. However, certain ASEAN countries, such as Myanmar, for example, are facing the Rohingya crisis. What do you think should be done to solve this issue?
Well, in ASEAN, there are potential conflicts even between members. The internal conflict remain internal. And as I said, in the past 51 years, there was no conflict between ASEAN member states. That's the good things. On Rohingya, of course, is a serious problem which is happening in Myanmar. ASEAN member countries have been trying to be part of the solutions, in particular to help the Rohingya's people to have better access to humanitarian assistance. So that's why Indonesia, Malaysia, and even also Thailand have provided human assistance to Myanmar refugees within Myanmar. But the most difficult part is the political solutions, namely how Myanmar ultimately give the final status of the Rohingyas to be the legal citizen of Myanmar. I think this is a process. This is something that cannot be done in 1 or 2 years. But Myanmar has agreed to receive those refugees who fled to Bangladesh to return. I believe together, ASEAN countries would convince Myanmar, would put a gentle pressure to find the political, the final solution, namely the political status of Rohingyas within the context of the sovereignty of Myanmar.
Let's talk about Eurasia now. While there are currently many issues going on in Eurasia, such as the US-Iran relations and Brexit, what are some of the pressing issues that Eurasian countries need to address and solve immediately?
Well, you know, ASEAN was established against the backgrounds of potential conflicts. But the key to the success of ASEAN is dialogue. I think it's important for all countries in the Eurasia, in the Central Asia, to begin the process of dialogue. This in dealing with problems of Afghanistan, the problems of U.S., Iran, a potential sanctions, but likewise in a larger context of Europe, like the Brexit. So in the end, to me, dialogue is the answer to these problems. And it is good that in Central Asia, they have developed a good start by developing a certain organization dealing with trade and investment, economic cooperation, political and security.
That was all the time that we have for today. We've come to the end of our program. Thank you very much for joining us
today. Thank you very much.
That was Hassan Wirayuda, former Foreign Minister of Indonesia. And you're watching Interview of the Day with me, Bilqis Bahari. Thanks for watching and see you again soon.